time. Better sit back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin getting. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk. Look, I played the game, I missed a shot. I had the answer, then forgot. I knew one day my pop finance for not, my not, flexing. I fell out and cut the check, my not, paralyzed the set, but I've been taking hits like I can die like innocent. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop it, the nigga, the serpent, determined, the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in the lands. I'm also a mood. LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my guts. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the dough and I come at the cut. Yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Yeah, mama, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who trying to battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be?
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Uptown Charlotte at rain-soaked Bank of America Stadium. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerged from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Philadelphia Eagles. The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were very good in the win over Dallas a week ago.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A big play there on the catch and run.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, it makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup.
Nice methodical opening drive here. They're already into field goal range. They're in a good spot. You know that people like to take a shot in this part of the field. But at the same time, as methodical as they've been, they might want to run the ball a little bit here, too.
And just on the outskirts of the red zone, they have options now. Either way, though, they've come out with a purpose.
On second down, it's Sanders. And he'll get a couple here down to the 22.
But that call makes sense, because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
I see an extra defensive back on the field. A little surprise here on third and one. Wilson. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow, because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
And they'll work this down to the 15 for a pickup of 4.
I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it, because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, just keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
And for a second straight play, just nowhere to go thanks to this Carolina defense. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7, as that one officially a loss of 1. They go play action with Wilson. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked up by Troy Pride. And the Panthers are going to get possession here as they force the opening drive turnover.
Well, that is a quick lesson on how difficult this defense is to throw against, an interception on their initial drive of the ball game.
Now we know why their offensive staff spent the entire week awake trying to prepare for this one, because you can't totally shy away from throwing the football. But at the same time, you're looking at them and going, where are the weaknesses? How are we going to move it?
One of the top defenses in the NFL for a reason. We just saw one example right there.
Off the option, here's McCaffrey.
And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you. Establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. This is McCaffrey on the give. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Less than a minute to go here in a scoreless first quarter to this point. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Looking at a 2nd and 11 now after the loss. And he's going to be met at about the 43. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. No score after 1 on EA Sports. The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Now this time he'll look. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Call it a loss of 4 there on the sack. And speaking of the number 4, it brings up 4th down now. So on 4th down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. And that ball's going to angle out at the 3-yard line. A beauty.
Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in one.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, you know, this club, there were some reports earlier in the week, and most have heard this by now, so-called unnamed sources that were saying all is not rosy in that locker room. There's whispers that one or two guys, CD, have kind of had enough of how things are going and have been going. How would you handle that as a coach?
Well, you and I both know all the coaches that we've dealt with and come in contact with. They'd love to get their hands on those unnamed sources, wouldn't they?
but they know that that's not possible. So I think they've got to go in there and make sure that this isn't a distraction. They also know that once the grumbling starts, it becomes a slippery slope and it's hard to stop the fall. But I think you need to sit some guys down and say, hey, look, we're still hoping to be a playoff team this year. We need you guys to be bought in with what we're doing. Come on, let's get on board.
On third down, Wilson eluding the pressure right. It's caught by Sanders. And he is out up around the 15-yard line.
Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got him the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
Now they have a little more space to maneuver from the 15, first and 10. Throwing is Wilson. And he's going to be brought down. Back at his own 6-yard line. Derrick Brown forced his way through, drops him for a loss of 10 yards. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Now it's Wilson. And that's going to be incomplete.
You definitely would have liked to have hit on that one, because now you've got a third and long showing up, and you just know defense is going to be getting after it. They are pinning their ears back, and they are coming.
The Eagles on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This will be third and forever. The gun, it's Wilson, and it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That looks like it's going to be 2 empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over game plan, overthink things. Get back to what works.
33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Panthers will take over in terrific field position. They run with McCaffrey off the option. Tackled by Ashton Davis up from the secondary.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Off the option, here's McCaffrey. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
Sometimes you're aligned perfectly and the play comes to you, and sometimes you got to cover some ground to go make the play, as we just saw there.
We saw a great example of perseverance right there on that play.
Got to be careful. They might want to throw one over his head as this game progresses.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. Touchdown, Carolina! DJ Moore, his third touchdown now on the year, as his guys are first out of the scoreboard here this afternoon. Footing always a concern, but the extra point's up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. It hasn't gone particularly well for them, that's obvious. In these conditions, no points so far. They've got to get that offense on track. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think, he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because 2 interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. On play action, they'll throw. That is caught by Anderson. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7.
Remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Try the option left, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Play fake. He'll look to throw. And he's got it. And he will take it across for Panthers touchdown. DJ Moore with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And that'll make the score 14 to zip. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because
and for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think, okay, he's a guy in all the commercials now.
Yeah, I think he's doing okay. So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
They go play action here on first down. He'll buy some time right. That's caught. It's McCaffrey again. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. The ball on the 8 still could get a first down technically, 2nd and 7. He'll look to throw. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
Now Wilson on first down. He finds his tight end, Goddard. That's complete. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. Give him nine there on the first down completion. Brings up second and a yard. Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line, second and a yard. Play action, it's Wilson. He's going deep for Brown. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Xavier Woods with a pick. And the Panthers are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line. Well, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. 4 seconds left, and there's the timeout. In field goal range and a chance to tack on three before intermission. Now whistles. Flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. This from 44 yards out, left hash. Gonzalez's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Hey, Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. He's going to look deep for more. And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone, you throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone multiple times. Tried to target him again deep there, but unsuccessful. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll set up to throw. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough. First down. And now the red flag out on the field. We'll have a challenge forthcoming. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah,
it
certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, That's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Trying to shake off the interception from the left. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. Back quite a ways here, facing second and 19. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson. And my goodness, another interception. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Oh, and he pulled it right. It's no good. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together.
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. After the sack, it's second and 19 and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Now Wilson. And Sanders has got it complete. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try to get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there. You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Meanwhile, Wilson's throw here taken in as he's able to find Goddard. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Again, Wilson. And this is caught by Watkins. That catch good for only a couple.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn.
And now here's another interception. Jeremy Chin picks it off, and the Panthers will take over here at their own 14-yard line. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. They start on the ground with McCaffrey, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Give the tackle to Hassan Reddick.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And that's complete to McCaffrey. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line.
One of the more productive and durable players up until last year. Remember, in 2019, 116 catches, which was an all-time record for NFL running backs. Trying to come back from an injury filled 2020, just 17 catches on the year. Sure is great to see him.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big play there for Carolina. That's evidence of why you spend a high draft pick on a receiver, isn't it, Charles?
It certainly is. His ability to make plays like that, and we've seen flashes of it from him so far in his rookie season. But also, it opens things up for the rest of the offense because they have to bring their attention to him as well.
Buying time to his left. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Second and 10 now, third quarter from Charlotte.
Tackle,
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. To the right side, and he's got more complete. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. So 8 yards on the completion there, and that's going to bring up a 4th down. And that is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we'll begin it with a field goal try here. Oh, this ball hangs out to the right. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
Well, they can probably live with that with this late lead in the 4th quarter. That's one of the few things that's gone wrong.
You're exactly right. This one was well in hand. That kick there was more for cosmetics, you know, to add to their score. Not getting it, that shouldn't harm them at all.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. This one certainly has not gone according to script. You would have thought on paper that this offense would have its way here, but they certainly have not, and they trail big. After this, it figures to be a quiet trip home. Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A big connection on that one. 32 yards.
Well, that's something you haven't had to talk about much this game. A nice big play right there. But this team, overall, they haven't done a whole lot offensively.
Well, they're still sitting on the goose egg. We talk about defenses having pride in a shutout. This offense wants to get rid of that zero.
They'll throw on 1st down with Wilson. 20, 10, touchdown, Philadelphia. A.J. Brown, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Eagles are finally on the board here in the 4th quarter. Wilson gonna throw for it. Complete at the 1. And he will get into the end zone to cut the lead a little bit further. Well, it's still an uphill battle from here, that's for sure, but that makes it a 2-score game.
And now we see why teams practice so much on the 2-point conversion, why you have more than one play ready, because you may need multiples throughout a ball game. There's a great example right there.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Now, there are 2 scores on the plus side. Still time here in this 4th quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation.
It got his man complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A big play that time through the air. 36 yards. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up 1st and 10. And finally out of bounds all the way down to about the 2. A big play there for Carolina.
Even with a big lead here in the 4th, it still bombs away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is 1st and goal. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the 1.
Well, he did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone, trying his best to get there in this game. So far, he's been denied.
Now this time he'll look to throw. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It's a loss of 7. And now it's 3rd down.
50, Mike's 50. Come on.
They'll set up a throw. Forced out to his left. Oh, this will be incomplete. The rush gets home just as he was letting that go. That could have been worse. Instead, it's fourth down.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
And it's a fake. He's going to throw it. The fake field goal catches everyone by surprise. And the Panthers are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Taking it about the one. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Remember, they have won three straight, but getting to four straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. On first down, Wilson. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Play action. Now Wilson. And my goodness, another interception. Xavier Woods with a pick. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. Yes, folks, that is his third interception, and I'm going to use one of the most overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to...
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
We always hear a lot of veterans on the defensive side of the football. They talk about smelling blood in the water, putting pressure on a rookie. They got to him there to force it free, but couldn't recover it.
And you mentioned the pressure. Rookie quarterback, you're going to bring more pressure at him at all times because you don't know how he's going to hold up. He was fortunate there. Luck was on his side, able to recover that fumble.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. The Panthers on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and a mile. He wants it all for the end zone. And oh no, it's incomplete. Well, it's a touchdown if he holds on, but somehow took his eyes off of it, falls to the ground, and brings up fourth down. On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Now, this game went off the rails early for them and never really got back on track. And these fans, they were expecting to be on the other side of the scoreboard. But that is not the case as we play on here in this fourth quarter. Wilson's throw complete here to his receiver, Brown. And he's got a first down as he's going to be taken down. But a very nice pickup there just in front of the two-minute warning. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. This is caught. It's Brown. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. This will be caught once again by Brown. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Flush to his right. This will be caught by Brown. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as it comes with a minute 4 left to go in the game. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. Touchdown, Eagles! Miles Sanders, his second touchdown on the season. And the Eagles have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth.
And yeah, that touchdown counts for their team, but I think it counts more for the fantasy guys, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's just something maybe positive to look at on film, but this one's over, let's be honest.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one.
On a return, here comes Smith out of the end zone. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. This is McCaffrey. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. So their task a little bit more difficult now, second and 13 that they're walking up on. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete. Despite the lead here in the fourth, they're still taking shots.
Not content to sit on this lead at all. To me, it raises the question of what's right in this game nowadays. Do you sit on the ball and run it because you have enough of a lead? Or do you try and extend it because you always feel like the other team can come back?
Extend it. Have some fun. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Well, Fletcher Cox, he's been doing this for a lot of years, and another sack to his ledger there. So this one is over. A victory for Carolina. And they've got to feel good about this performance. I think you'd agree. Matched up against a top five defensive unit in the league, and they pretty much had their way.
Yeah, that was the interesting part about it, because normally when we see this defense play, they have their opportunities, and they make their plays, don't they? They knock them back on their heels. They take the ball away. They change field position. In this case, what you said is so apt. They had their way with them, took it to them, and knocked them back on their heels and surprised the heck out of them.
So for the Panthers, they move back over 500 at 3.
Salute when you sink. That jealousy is an ocean, and you either float or you sink. Moment of truth, credit check. You not a fool, BB King. I'm in love with the moves. Don't cut me up, I got finishing moves. Look, salute when you see me. Slid through all the commotion, breaking loose. I got an ad on TV, popping out on them. I'm politicking, probably in a section where you not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted, playing all gold, ain't no stopping in it. Look.